The Central Executive Committee of the HSPDP today held a meeting to discuss three agendas relating to the state, including the law and order situation in Shillong, the proposed Sixth Schedule Amendment Bill, and the interstate border dispute with Assam. HSPDP President KP Pangnyang, Cabinet Minister Renikton Tongkhalingdaw, MDC of Malkun Rao Martil Mukhim, and other senior leaders of the party were in attendance. Following the meeting, Party President KP Pangnyang informed press persons of their suggestions to the Sixth Schedule Amendment Bill. The party suggests inserting the word governor in place of president in paragraph 12A subsection B of the Sixth Schedule of the Indian Constitution.
In the urgent CEC of the party, today we have taken up three important agenda. Number one, we had discussed the law and order situation arise in the city in this few days back. See, from the party, we have expressed our concern. The unfortunate incident took place with one of our leader of the Surrendered HNLC, Mr. Cherisfield, thank you. As a party, we felt it's a great loss to the society, even to these family members. But we are very regret that this incident took place, which is not expected by each and every body or section of the society. At the same time, we express our gratefulness and appreciate the decision taken by the state government that it has instituted the independent judicial inquiry to look into the matter in deeply and at length, and to find out what is the real incident took place, so that the law of the land will take its own course of action. That is our concern from the party, and we appreciate the step taken by the government of the day. Within these 2-3 days back, the Honorable Chief Minister of the day informed the people of the state, informed the district council, that the process to collect information and suggestion from the state is still going on. So from the party, since we have submitted many letters and memorandums, the need to amend the particulars, paragraph 12AB to the Constitution of India by inserting the words president in the 12AB to the Constitution of India.
By inserting the word governor.
By the words governor in its place. So that is our demand from the party, so that it will empower, the state government. Because as of now, the government of the day, we don't have much power or legislation power to legislate, especially to protect the uniqueness of our culture, to protect or to legislate the so-called land tenure system in our state. For example, we have seen that in the recent years, the Meghalaya Legislative Assembly had passed two important laws, legislation like exemption of the MMDR Act of 1957, so that it will enable the state to take a call or to legislate while using and legislating the property, the mineral resources of our state. But as of now, we don't have that power. So we request the government of the day to take a final call that our suggestion from the party to be considered, if acceptable, to take it as the official resolution of the government resolution of the state and to send it to the government of India. That is our request to the government, and this is the resolution that today we have taken in our meeting. Long, long pending issue of the border, interstate border problem. Since the party had raised this issue from time and again, we are very grateful to the government of the day that this border issue has been taken seriously by the government. And now the process to find out solution is on the way. So we express our gratefulness. At the same time, we will cooperate. We will, you know, call each and every stakeholder to unitedly come forward and to find, you know, concrete solution and permanent solution. And thirdly, we, the party, we will never forget all those hill state fighters at the time when the people of our state, they raised the slogan, no hill state, no rest, means at the time when they fight the state of Meghalaya. We remember that many leaders, they have contributed a lot. And we have so many volunteers. They have rendered a lot to attain and to get this Meghalaya statehood. So now it is high time for us as a party to remember those volunteers, to salute those leaders before the state of Meghalaya will celebrate the 50 years attainment of statehood or Golden Jubilee celebration. We as the party, we feel fit and we feel appropriate to remember all those volunteers and hill state fighters, irrespectively either from the APHLC cadres or including all those self-volunteers under the umbrella of the Hill State People Democratic Party. We are rendering our, you know, our salute, and we will not forget their contribution for the entire state. So on the 10th of November this year,